part of the day, which we are going to look here, we're going to play a little bit of a game here. And you guys, since you are the lucky few that have decided to stay on, you get the opportunity to win some fantastic prizes, including a Chromebook. We've got various little goodie bags and some things that we'll be showing you guys here as we get to that part of it. The first part of it, though, is first I want to ask you this question. How many of you guys learned something today? Give yourself a round of applause. Whatever it is that you learn, share that. The biggest thing of knowledge, it used to be that owning things is what gave you a lot of power, basically gave you a lot of power in the world. Now it's sharing. Sharing is what's earned from, what's rewarding now. So make sure that you're sharing with the EdTech team hashtag. We've got some fantastic photos and sharing things like that as well through the EdTech team hashtag on Twitter. Tomorrow, we have another little game for you. It's a little bingo game in which you are going to be given some cards that I'll be handing out. You'll put up tomorrow at the registration desk. Right? When you come in, you can just grab one of these. And there's various tasks that you have to do in order to get them signed off. In the end, these are going to go into a raffle for another prize at the end of the day tomorrow. So look out for that. We'll give you free stuff today. We'll also give you free stuff tomorrow. So so my next event is to continue your learning after you leave our event here in the next 2 days. We have an online course, or online department now, basically. And we produce a lot of online classes that are based around various parts of the Google Apps suite, as well as some other things. We have online book studies as well, and we have some different some ideas about different courses that we may have that we have going. So there are you get university credit for these courses as well. It's great for those of us that are in the international setting. Can't always make it back to go to a professional development. That earns credit, but you can do that within these programs that we offer. So you go to edtechteam.com/online to see more about that. So we have a boot camp that is going on as well, that's going on currently. And these are little examples of different courses that we've got. We've currently got them only in English, but we're translating them into Spanish. There's demand in other languages as well, or we'd be willing to do that. But you get some idea there about the types of things that we're taking a look at. Some product-based ones, as well as some more general, broad courses that are coming out as well around design thinking and spaces and things like that. Other things we do we're known for doing these events, these types of summits, but we do offer a lot of other services as well, like boot camps, which are workshops for 20 to 30 teachers, one workshop leader, and you work with them all day, for example. We do keynotes, we do another new adventure for us, it's called Impact Labs. So if you take a look at edtechteam.com/PD, you'll see we do a lot more than just Google Summits. So if you are interested in any of those, and some people talked to me already about this, if you're interested, go to our request form, and you can fill that out. Since you're in this region, that information comes to me, and then I get in contact with you about what we might be able to do to help you guys meet your PD goals and needs over the next few years or whatever. There are also, if you take a look, you guys can go to this website now, the TIFF poster. You can download these. We tweet these out pretty much monthly, I think we've been doing recently. And they're little hints, little posters you should print out or you can display in your classroom. So there's an example of one there if you'd like to go to that. And edtech.team/TIFFs poster. If you want to take a photo of that, you can, and then go visit that again if you'd like. In the photo booth. So the kids have been taking some photos in the photo booth, and they've been uploading some of those. And if I if I go to that website, I'll pull it up here. So there you go. So we've got some of these photos. This is what you were actually doing. the power of the green screen. So feel free to visit that site. Squid Head is always popular. It's a fun one. And we'll download those photos if you'd like to take those. If you are, if you're taking photos, and hopefully you are, you can also upload your own to our site. So if you go to this, so zantech.team, so Taiwan photos, you can, it's a collaborative Google Photos album. So you can add your own photos to there if you'd like. It's always fun to get your from the experience from your perspective as well. So make sure you check that out and add that to that to our book with photos. So Taiwan photos, we've got this example photo showing you why we say this set. So what we have now is our demo slam. So this is a chance for our presenters to kind of get up here and have a little competition to see who's going to be the demo slam winner. So you guys just need to sit back and watch. And at the end, you all need to make sure that you have downloaded the EdTech Team Events app on your mobile device. So please go ahead and do that right now if you haven't already. Just open up the App Store or your Google Play Store, and you can search for EdTech Team. Next slide here. If you search for it, and you search for EdTech Team Events, it'll come up, or just EdTech Team, and it comes up. There's a section in there for the demo slam, and I'm updating that now. You're going to be voting. You need to vote for one of the people who present. Right? So it's not that you vote on each one. You're going to pick the person that you want to win. You tap on the vote button when we're ready at the end, after everyone's done their presentations, and you get to win prizes. So everyone who votes, if you vote, you can win. So if you're not voting, then sorry, you're not going to win more fantastic prizes here. So go ahead and make sure you've downloaded that as well. I will say, I know that it wasn't as clear as we could have done earlier, with that in that same app, that's how you also give the feedback to the presenters with a little emoji scale. So make sure you have that installed by now. If you haven't installed now, make sure you get it installed by tomorrow. And you can always stop by the registration desk and we can show you how. So you tap on the little vote for your favorite slam and you get to vote right within that. And we'll be selecting the double slam winners from those votes. Okay? So we are going to do this. This is a little bit of coordination here for us. We're going to do what we like to call the doggle dance. Some people come up and they like to use their own computers, so we'll be still swapping those out. We have a 3-minute timer set up on our Chromebook that we'll be sharing up here that the people can see. And once the time goes, they have to walk away, and their time is up. The idea here is to impress you with an educational use, hopefully, of something within the Google Apps suite, and the idea is it's a slam, so it's like you're trying to show everybody else something else. So a little bit of attitude, a little bit of banter, always helps with that. Okay? So the order we're going to go in is the order that's in the app. I'm going to be updating that data here in just a second as well. I can get a couple more people to drop in there. You don't see any of the people who visited it. Don't worry, they'll get in there very, very shortly. So first up is going to be Swan Yo. So everybody in this Swan. Round of applause.
Should we get the podium mic?
The podium mic on?
Yeah. Robert. In Google, we built, this is how nerdy we are.
what's your favorite device? Laptop, tablet, or a cell phone?
So we welcome to the Google Summit because we're innovative teachers and we want our kids to be active. But we also know every now and then we need to just provide information and give a slideshow. Many of us are familiar with how to do slideshows. I'm going to show us just one more quick advance that will help your slideshows be a little more engaging through animation, because the students need and love animation these days. So if we've done slideshows as we know, students love the engagement even when they're sitting and watching. As many of us know, we know how to start a slideshow and we know how to insert word art and clip art and change our themes. We also, some of us know, if you're a little more advanced with clip art, you can do things such as transitions and show things that come in and out. If I play this, our slideshows have become more interactive. We can make them slide in, we can make them slide out, we can make them play. I just made the slideshow since it's sitting in this room. These are pictures from our website. A new way for kids, and I was taught this by a 9-year-old just last week, but many of us don't know, is as we're adding in our pictures, we can also add in. So if I go to Google and I just grab an image like I normally would to draw it in, if I go up here, we have the long forgotten toolbar. If we select the toolbar, we can change the size, we can change the color, the type. If we pick animation, our boring pictures come to life. So then I just pick a Superman that can come in and I can just drop it right into my slideshow. Another quick way to add animations and GIFs is a Google extension.
Right up here I have my GIF, it's called
Giphy. I can just pull GIFs directly from there into my Google slideshows as well to help them to come to life quickly without taking a lot of time. it makes our slideshows and our documents come to life a lot more quickly. Thank you.
Looks like this computer is not really happy for the demo to slam it. Screen went off again.
That's touch TV.
Never mind. Can you hide that? Upload. I'm going to take a camera as well for you all.
Make sure I'm trying to show you these all real pictures. I'm going to upload it on my mobile. Oh my god, scary! Going to here, I'm going to copy these whole things over. Paste it here. Oops. Okay.
Amigo. 감사합니다.
focus, they need to keep the track of the progress. And I stretch it to them, and basically, like, this is a spreadsheet where I have the success criteria. You can see on the yellow tab, these are the success criteria for my projects. And well, in the black row, it's just the rewards, and my merits, give the merits to give them some rewards for each success criteria they complete. And the three color coded so I can see who's struggling, who has completed. If they need help, they could always go to the student who's ahead and look for help to those students. And after Google Sheets, well, there's Google Doc, but at the end of the project, we evaluate. So, we evaluate using Google Doc, and I create a template, and I give it to them, and they write the reflection, evaluation, and add screenshots to the project. The last part is I screencast a couple of my students in screencast. So what I do is ask them to create a 10-minute screencast explaining what they have done using whatever projects they did and talk about the evaluation, and then they can share this video with their parents from Google Drive. So that's the end. Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks all our presenters there for sharing that information with us and those cool tips and tricks. So if you guys go to your app, you will be able to refresh the screen. So if you don't see all of the names there, you should see eight sessions. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. Now I'm going to I won't have that page up here in a second. I'm going to pull that down. I'm going to give you guys some time right now. You should be able to go in and click on the person's name that you want to win. Yeah.
can't do this, is, which is for some reason my computer does this a lot, and I have to figure out why. That's okay. So you do Google set time for whatever time limit you want, you get a nice little countdown timer. So you do the iPhone that was coming out because that would have been a nice thing to say for me. So
winner.
How's that?
got a world-facing camera on it, so that two cameras on it, so it's pretty cool how you get old images to taste them.
You want to try to
get the whoever wins this, they get they can view.
Here we go, drum roll.
Alright, here we go. Thank you very much for all you guys have done and shared with us.